As we saw earlier, there are many examples of games and animations in the Scratch website. We can pick one and try to understand and modify it. We'll use this one as an example. If you're working offline, you can download it from the resources page in the course website. This is what it looks like. Click on See Inside. We can now read the code. Don't worry if you don't understand everything in the code at this point. Hit the green flag to run it. You'll see a dance animation with sounds. If you want to stop it, press the red button next to the green flag. In the program, there are two sprites. So far, we only had one sprite, the cat. You can have many sprites, each with its own look and behavior. If you click on them, you can see the script they're following. Each sprite can have several looks. Click on it, and then on the Costumes tab. As a challenge, we want the dinosaur to move faster. Try to find out how to achieve that. We can give you a hint for this. Try changing the glide time. We also want the girl to move while she dances, so we'll introduce a move block. Let's try it out. What happened? When the girl reaches the edge, we can no longer see her. We'll fix this by introducing an if on edge bounce block. Let's test it. Oops, she's now turned upside down. Let's change her rotation style and test it again. Good. She is now moving as expected. Don't forget to save the modified program on your computer. You may have noticed that you don't need to understand everything in the code to modify it. In fact, we haven't even looked at the code for the background, and yet we were able to successfully modify the behavior of the two sprites. Now let's analyze how the background changes when the program is running. Try clicking on Stage and going to the Backdrops tab. If you press on the different images, you'll see the backdrops used. To see the script, press the Scripts tab. By looking at the code, we can tell that every half a second it will change the backdrop, and at the same time, it will play a song. In this video, we've had a look at an animation that we chose from the Scratch website. In the next video, we'll create our own animation.